Good afternoon and welcome to All About Animals. I'm Sherry Graditor and I am at HAHS, which is Hooved Animal Humane Society. Hopefully I did that right this time.
Very good.
In Woodstock, our guest is Tracy McGonigle, who is the executive director of HAHS. And we're going to talk a little bit about the organization. So here we go, Tracy. Track how an animal winds up here.
Okay, we are a nonprofit 501c3 organization, and our mission is to take in animals who have been the victims of criminal abuse and neglect. So as a rule, we don't take in owner turn-ins. I will if I have space and if there's a hardship, but about 95 to 99, maybe even 100% of our animals come from criminal investigations into abuse and neglect, either ours or through any of the law enforcement authorities throughout the state. Actually, that's how they get here. So when they get here, they're usually in pretty bad condition. So we spend a lot of time rehabilitating these animals. The biggest problem that we see is starvation. Actually, that's probably the most common problem that we have with all of our animals here. So we have some great veterinarians that come here. They get us all started on a refeeding program. And it takes a very long time to refeed starved animals. But we start with that, we rehabilitate them. A lot of them, what I should say is that we are the Hooved Animal Humane Society, predominantly horses, but we also have pot-belly pigs, we have sheep, we have goats right now, we also have a llama. So we have all types of hooved animals that we rescue. And the majority of what we see in all of them is starvation, like I talked about. Veterinarians will prescribe a refeeding program for us. We'll have the animals on that program. We also see a lot of hoof problems in all of these animals, and we'll have the farriers out working on them. And the goal for every animal that comes in here is to be rehabilitated, and we want to find them all happy, loving, permanent homes. That's our goal, and so that's what we go for.
And basically, you do that through adoption, and what are your criteria for an adoption?
We do that through adoption, yes. And the criteria are you have to have experience with the animal that you're trying to adopt, meaning that species. We have people who want to adopt horses. Great, we want to see some prior experience. A lot of people want to have a horse on their very own property. They have to have had horses on their property before. That's a requirement. But we also will adopt to someone who's going to board that horse at a commercial boarding facility or something. That's fine, because then there are other people who will be helping,
who are
will be feeding, who have the experience. So, and we do adopt out of state, provided that I can do a home visit, because with every adoption, you have to send in an application. You have to come and meet with us, meet with the animals. You have to provide a veterinary reference, and for the horses, in the case of horses, a farrier reference as well. And we also conduct a home visit. So I will do out of state adoptions or honor out of state adoptions as long as I can do
a
home visit and possibly follow-up visits past the adoption. Because we also want to give the people who adopt our animals a great amount of support. So if they have any questions or things after the adoption, we're not going to leave them hanging. We want to be there. We want to help them.
And I would imagine, in addition to refeeding, in a lot of cases you're dealing with animals that have been mistreated, neglected, and just don't have a really great opinion of two-legged mammals, of people.
And yes.
And you've got some work to do there with attitude and getting them to feel secure around people again. I imagine that's the second half of this refeeding once you do that.
There is the emotional damage that's been done with that comes along with that neglect. There definitely is the emotional damage. And we work on that. This is Tinkerbell, by the way. I don't know if we introduced her in honor of Halloween. But we work on that, building trust, showing them that people aren't so bad. We can actually be pretty good. And you have to get there. You have to have them accept you and trust you. And that way you can build the relationship. And that way a prospective adoptive person can build the relationship too.
Absolutely. So you've got trust issues to build.
Absolutely.
And then you've got to learn more. Now we're going to talk about horses, because what percentage of what comes through here is horses?
The vast majority.
The vast majority.
Yeah.
So you need to know if that horse is rideable,
right?
If that horse is kid safe.
Right.
I mean, there are a lot of things that, and I would imagine that that's done here during this period while you're doing your refeed program and getting them back in shape. you're getting to know what the personality of the animal is too.
Right, absolutely. And we have some animals here who are great riding companions. We have others who would just be suitable as pasture pals. And we have trainers that we work with. We have one that comes on site. And once a horse, and we're basically speaking of horses here, but we do actually work with the goats and things too.
Oh, goats are wonderful. I love them.
They're great. Oh, they're so much fun. But with the horses, we have them evaluated, see what their capabilities are physically. Mm-hmm. And then that's where the emotional component comes in too. You're starting to work with them, getting them to trust being handled, and you know, that letting them know that this can be fun. It's fun to go riding. It's fun to do things like that. And seeing what the horse likes to do, what the horse is capable of. And that way, when a person calls and says, oh, I'm looking for this kind of a horse, you know, do you have anything like that? We can really, we do our best to match, just completely match.
Oh, yeah.
The, you know, the best. Because our goal is to make a permanent placement.
Sure.
So we don't want them to have to come back.
And as I tell people all the time with dogs and cats, and it's the same with horses, somebody's going to call you and say, I want a dapple gray horse with a black mane and tail. And I say to all of them, the wrapper doesn't matter. It's what's inside that
counts. Exactly.
Yeah.
Yes. No.
So it may not be the most beautiful horse. It may not be your dream horse, black, shining black, or a beautiful Palomino, or, hey, that wasn't nice, child, or whatever it is that you're talking about. Tinkerbell is very opinionated. She says, don't tell me what to do. Yes, she's very sweet, though. So it's not that you come to an organization to adopt an animal because you want, I want an Arabian, I want a rose gray Arabian.
We do get that. People do want that. And I say, you know, really, what you're saying, it's not the wrapper, it is what's inside.
That's right.
Come and see, because you really want to match the personality.
Sure. If it's a child, you need something that's safe with kids.
Absolutely.
If it's an experienced rider, it's a whole different class of horse.
Exactly.
Yeah, and now, we've got these little pot-bellied pigs just running around and having a wonderful time here.
Are you getting any of them?
Are you hearing them? Yes. And they came into you, why?
They came into us, it was as a result of a criminal investigation into abuse and neglect in one of the counties around here. And they need us to help rehabilitate them because we have expertise in that area,
Sure. Obviously.
So we're working with them, and they're doing great.
I can tell they're getting... running around here like maniacs. And then eventually we'll go up for adoption?
Yeah,
they will
go up for adoption, yeah. Mm-hmm. But we want to make sure that they're okay.
Of course.
And so we'll have them for a while and evaluate them. And also we will spay and neuter them before they go out.
Good. Yeah. And we talked a little bit about the fact that breeders oftentimes starve the baby pigs so that they stay small, and everybody says they're micro mini baby pot-bellied pigs. And the truth is, when you get them home, if you feed them a normal diet, and often the breeder of the pigs will tell you not to feed them enough food. We'll say it needs X number of cups of food a day so that the animal will stay malnourished.
Right, and that's, people think, I'm going to adopt myself a micro pig, a teacup piglet, something like that. Well, that little animal may stay little for a couple of weeks, but that animal is going to get big if you feed the animal properly. And that's probably the biggest thing. We have so many people coming here looking for these little tiny piglets, and piglets are little, but they get bigger.
They grow. Just like kids.
And people don't realize that. And they're so cute and adorable when they're little, and I think they're cute and
loud,
big.
And loud when you pick them up. Oh yes. And we are going to go into a barn. We're going to look at some horses.
Yes.
Tell me what we're going to be looking at.
Okay, you're going to look at two of our more recent arrivals that we have here, and they also came from another investigation into abuse and neglect. One of the horses, before they came here, died. Actually, two died. One was found dead on the farm. Another one was dying, and we took that horse up to the University of Wisconsin Veterinary Hospital, and the horse did not survive up there. But these two, they're in starved condition. I want to preface that, you know, before you see them, because they're in a little bit rough shape. But you know, this is for people
this
to see
is
what we
comes
do with.
In.
This is what comes in.
And then, with any luck at all, and if the animal is fortunate, and so are you, you wind up with a beautiful, vital, vibrant horse.
Yep.
Yes.
And we do. And as I said, we work very closely with veterinarians and you know, we go from there. Because starvation is the main thing we see, followed by hoof problems, emotional problems too.
Oh yeah.
And a lot of times skin issues as well. There are a lot of skin issues that go along with malnutrition because the skin, the integrity of the skin.
Well, and the internal organs start shutting down too. I mean, it's a big deal. But we are running out of time. And we're getting short on time, and there are a couple of more things I want to touch on.
Okay.
One of them is, as an organization, what do you need?
We need, well, as a 501c3 nonprofit, we always need donations, always. We always need that. We always need volunteers. In particular, actually right now, we have some new properties. And we need to fence those properties so we can put our animals on these properties. So we're always looking for fencing materials, things like that.
Donors who own fence companies and would like to do something as a charitable donation would be nice. Or provide fencing as a charitable donation would be nice.
Right.
Anything else on your wish list?
Well, they're a little bit larger items, but also shelters for the animals, shelters for horses.
Outdoor
shelters? Run-in sheds, loafing sheds for them. Because we do have this new property, and we can only move on it as we get it prepared.
Sure.
We received a lovely donation this year, and so we were able to pasture a portion of it and put a run-in shed on it. So now I have 3 goats, a llama in there.
Neat.
So, yeah, and so that's what we need. Also, we have more everyday items. We always need buckets. We always need pitchforks. We always need brushes, things like that. Food. We would like it to be the same kind of food.
Well, that's dollars for food because you want to keep continuity of feed.
Consistent.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm going to jump in the last, I believe, minute that we've got. If you would give people a phone number that they can reach you at, the address here.
Okay.
When you're open to the public.
Okay. Hooved Animal Humane Society. Our address is 10804 McConnell Road, Woodstock, Illinois. The phone number is 815-337-5563. And we are open to the public from 9 a.m. until 3 p.m. Monday through Friday. We have other office hours, but it's typically when we're open for people to just come in. But we can certainly set something up by an appointment. And we're open on Saturdays from 9 until about 1:30. But again, if anybody really wants to come here, give us a call
and we can
arrange that.
The whole idea is that the horses that are here, and how many do you have now?
We have 51 horses right now.
There are 51 horses waiting for the correct home.
Yes.
There are 51 horses that are being fed, which costs, as well as goats and sheep and a llama and pigs.
Yes.
They eat. They need their pens cleaned. There's lots of stuff that needs to be done. So dollars are important. But more than anything else, loving homes for these animals is really the goal.
That's the goal for every single one.
So if you can help. If you're looking for a new good friend, a companion, or especially a pasture buddy, give the organization a call and see what you can do.
And the animals are all welcome to stay here. We are a no-kill shelter, unless something's tremendously suffering and all that. So they're welcome to stay here, but I really want to find them all homes.
We'll go to Save a Pet and show you some of the dogs and cats available there for adoption.